Next, here tonight, the Tampa Bay community is still in mourning over the sudden passing of former Tampa Bay Buccaneer Vincent Jackson. He was found dead Monday in a Brandon hotel room.
ABC Action News sports anchor Kyle Berger joins us now with a closer look at Jackson's legacy and impact on the community.
The sadness of sudden loss comes right after the Buccaneers' biggest win in 18 years. Former Bucs receiver Vincent Jackson last played on the team in 2016, but his legacy will be remembered on and off the field.
My autograph football collection, you've been here, are usually always special guys. You know, and he was one.
Buccaneers superfan Larry Gasparino would always notice how much time Jackson devoted to fans, even at practice.
Stuck with me how great a guy he was, signing autographs for every little kid at training camp practice until he got taking care of everybody. He was such a nice, cordial guy.
Former Bucs kicker Martin Gramatica remembers Jackson as a larger-than-life personality.
He would brighten the room up. You know, when Vincent showed up, everybody knew, hey, he's here. You know, you could see him, a tall, big guy.
A pillar in the community, known for his charity work, Jackson was a big supporter of the military with his Jackson in Action 83 Foundation.
He was just an amazing person off the field. I mean, we saw the talent on the field, you know, three-time Pro Bowler. We saw his amazing career on the field, but he impacted so many people off the field. It's hard to explain. Yesterday when I heard the news, I mean, my stomach just dropped. Like, I was nauseous.
Vincent Jackson was just 38 years old. In Tampa, Kyle Berger, ABC Action News.